You can begin.
Listen, we've all had those moments. You're hungry, on the brink of starving. You ask your parents, what's for dinner? And they respond with the typical, we just ate 10 minutes ago. Parents, am I right? Anyways, I have a useful recipe that I learned from my mother, and that is both tasteful and filling. But first, you will need to collect your supplies. In order to begin this recipe, you will need 1.5 cups of white rice, which I have here, any brand. 1.5 cups of water, which is over there boiling. Or you could use milk, actually, but I didn't. 1 tablespoon of butter, divided. 1/4 of a cup of sugar, and a pinch of cinnamon sugar. Now to start cooking this recipe, you will need a medium saucepan and an oven preheated to medium level, but that doesn't exactly apply because it's a gas stove. But you get the idea. And first, these are steps that I already did. First, carefully pour the milk slash water into the pan, making sure not to spill any or as little as possible for the clumsier among us. And the next step is to let the milk slash water simmer until it is boiling. While we are waiting for that to boil, I will tell you how sweet rice was created and how it has changed the history. Sweet rice, which has many other names in other countries, such as arroz con leche, rouge au lait, and kheer, is found to have been a long-standing dessert staple for many countries, but more so for Asian countries due to rice being a main staple. In Canada and the United States, however, most variants of this recipe are of European descent. In the latter half of the 20th century, Asian, Middle Eastern, and Latin American recipes have also become more common. In New England, a popular pudding is made with long grain rice, milk, sugar, or in Vermont, they use maple syrup. This may be combined with nutmeg, cinnamon, and or raisins. This pudding is usually partially cooked on top of the stove in a double boiler and then finished in an oven. That means put it in an oven. In Nordic countries, however, rice porridge is a common dinner dish, and sometimes breakfast as well. It is made as a warm dish from rice cooked in milk. When served, it's commonly sprinkled with cinnamon, sugar, and a small knob of butter, and served with milk or fruit juice. And in Iceland, it is commonly served with cold svetur, which is a type of liver sausage. In different languages, it is called risengrød, which is Danish, risengrynsgrød, which is Norwegian, and don't mind my pronunciations either. Risipuro, which is Finnish, and herisgrætur, which is Icelandic. And the earliest rice pudding recipes were called white pot, and date from the Tudor period. One of the earliest recipes was written down by Gervase Markham in 1615. Rice pudding in England is traditionally made with pudding rice, milk, cream, and sugar, and is sometimes flavored with vanilla, nutmeg, jam, and or cinnamon. It can be made in 2 ways, in a saucepan or baking in an oven. And basically, if you listen to none of what I said during that interesting spiel on history of sweet rice, then all you need to know is that it's basically the same recipe, no matter where you are in the world, but when broken down, essentially, it is the smallest touches and ideals that make this dish common, but of the most rare in the world. Now back to the cooking. Now that the milk is boiled, carefully pour the milk slash water into the heat-proof dish that you have selected. Just carefully. I don't even.
Thank you.
And this is the point where you add all the good stuff, like the sugar.
Butter.
Now that the recipe is complete, please allow time to cool. I hope that you enjoy this meal, and I hope you are well prepared to teach it to someone else if needed. Feel free to take this recipe home and share it with your family and enjoy it. But remember, always add your own personal touches, because when you do, it tastes that much sweeter. Thank you.
Thank you very much.